Save your progress by pressing the save key, adding a name to your beat and confirming. You should keep saving your work frequently. Let's draw some new notes for the bass. I'm going to modify the build-up bass line to make it slightly different from the intro bass line. We are now duplicating the entire part. We're going back into the drum edit page to look for a good snare sound. We're using this for a roll in the breakdown. To make the main lead more powerful, you can duplicate it and shift the melody up by an octave. It's a pretty easy and popular trick. We're going to do this, but with slight changes to the melody of the higher part. We are now duplicating the entire part. To delete events, activate eraser mode. But make sure you change the mode after you finish deleting, otherwise you may delete another block accidentally. As the track progresses, you may want to move blocks around for a better fit. Duplicating and copying blocks. If you don't want the track to play back from the beginning over and over again, activate loop mode and set the left and right locators to the area that you currently want to edit. Gonna add some movement here by adding a few notes to this part. Now we'll make the outro by combining other parts together. Adding sweeps and effects to your track is a great way to build the atmosphere.